taken forever to get out of Tokyo because of the massive backup on the roads. The highways are shut down. We're on two-lane highway trying to get up to that region still. So it's just very slow going trying to get out of that region. At this point, we are hearing that all up to that region, rail lines continue to be closed, highways are closed, so access remains extraordinarily difficult. But as dawn is breaking here, because it's been daylight now for about the past 30, 40 minutes, we've started to hear that officials are starting to go to the region. The prime minister has already announced that he is boarding a helicopter and heading to the nuclear power plant, the Fukushima power plant. He wants to visit it. He wants to meet with the local officials and check to see exactly what is happening on the ground. He did announce that he was expanding the evacuation radius to about 10 kilometers surrounding that nuclear reactor. So that's going to be one of his main concerns heading up to this region, as is many of the people in the area. But the other big concern now is search and rescue. Now that dawn is broken, now that there's daylight, it's actually getting eyeballs in there and trying to figure out exactly the scope of the devastation that we're dealing with.
Yeah, also, Kyung, one of the reasons why they've expanded that evacuation area, we have reports at least coming to us from one of the news agencies that there could be a very high radiation level surrounding that nuclear power plant. Do you know anything more about that?
From what we've heard, the big issue, and this is what's being reported in the local press here, is that it's a power issue and that there's been trouble trying to keep the fissures and the reactors cool enough. And power to this entire challenging. We know that as we're heading up there, we're starting to see glimmers of that. But we can definitely say that the infrastructure is certainly going to be a challenge. And so trying to get power to the nuclear reactor is certainly going to be an issue. And that in turn is going to cause the problem that you're talking about.
Kyung, we know that the nuclear reactor, obviously a priority for the Prime Minister, Prime Minister Khan. But beyond that initial assessment with this helicopter tour, do you know what the rest of his day looks like?
It's very, very hard to say, Brooke, because it's such a fluid situation. What we have been hearing throughout the night, as we've driven through the night, from all the officials, is that they just had to wait until dawn broke. Now that there's daylight, they've got to get their people in there. They've got to understand and take a look. What are we looking at? The last good pictures that anyone had out of this region was, you know, at daylight yesterday, and that was, you know, 12 hours ago. So it's going to be a very different picture as this day is starting, and certainly a bigger understanding of exactly what we're dealing with.
And quickly, Kyung, I know that you have been in this car for hours and hours. You've been describing the gridlock you've experienced trying to get out of Tokyo, heading northward. Are you still experiencing the same bumper to bumper? Are those cars, are people trying to get out of town? Are they not moving?
The area that we're in now, it's actually moving quite well. It's a much more rural area. The gridlock that we were experiencing was commuter traffic, people trying to get to the suburbs. The area that we're going to is really out of the way. Unless you have family up in this region, you're not going to be heading there.
So, no one's heading
thankfully,
in the
we're
direction.
Actually moving now.
No one's heading in the direction of the epicenter. Okay, Kyung Lah, safe travels to you.